All suns and stars have a limited amount of energy. Once the sun has been extinguished and we've used up all the fuel in our planet and in our solar system, we will have to go into space to find a new home. Here, we will once again have plenty of energy from our new sun, and there may once again be lots of fuel buried in the ground. It may last for millions of years, but as before, the supply will eventually run out. We will eventually once again have to go find a new star to call our home. We can do this over and over again, but there is a fundamental problem with this strategy. Although new stars are constantly being born, there is a limited amount of nuclear fuel in the universe. Stars are powered by nuclear fusion, where atomic nucleuses combine together and are transformed from one element into another. As this continues, the atoms are eventually transformed into elements that are no longer useful for nuclear reactions. Eventually, elements useful for nuclear reactions will be depleted, and all energy in the universe will be dispersed. When this happens, no new stars will be able to be created. All the stars in the universe will go out one by one. What is shown here is based on the laws of physics as we presently understand them. After every star is extinguished, all life in the universe will end. However, our understanding of the universe is imperfect, and our knowledge is constantly growing. No one knows what we may discover in the future, and if this fate may yet be avoided.
Detailed information about this is available in the video on this channel titled Thermodynamics and the End of the Universe. Please subscribe for notifications when new videos are ready.